Bad Case of Stripes by David Shannon, published by Scholastic Books. Carmela Cream loved lima beans, but she never ate them. All of her friends hated lima beans, and she wanted to fit in. Cream was worried about what other people thought of her. Today she was feeling even more than usual. This first day of school, she couldn't decide what to wear. There were so many people impressed. She tried 42 outfits, none seemed quite right. She put on a pretty red dress, looked in the mirror, and she screamed. Mother ran to the room and she screamed too. Oh my heavens, you're completely covered in stripes. That was certainly true. Carmela was striped from head to toe. She looked like a rainbow. She felt this forehead. You feel right? She said. I mean, fine, but just look at me. You get back in bed this evening. You're not going to school today. Carmela was relieved. She didn't want to miss the first day of school, but she was afraid of what other kids would say. She had no idea what it was, all those pretty stripes. That afternoon, Dr. Bubble came around that examined Carmela. What's extraordinary? I've never seen anything like it. Are you having coughing, sneezing, runny noses, ache, pain, chills, hot flashes, dizziness, drowsiness, shortness of breath, or uncontrolled breathing? No, Carmela told him. I feel fine. Well then, I don't see any reason why she shouldn't go to school tomorrow. There's some women that should close those shirts for the day. So no one reach me. Next day was disaster. Everyone at school lost her credit. They called her Carmela Cran, a nice little lollipop. Tried best or acted as everything were normal. The class decided to pledge allegiance. Her stripes are red, white, blue, and she broke out in stars. Other kids thought it was great. One said, let's play Sam Pokeboard dots. Sure enough, Cora turned and broke dot. He said, checkerboard, chatter square card to skin. Or you're changing card score, changing your fast, you can change channels on a TV. And then Mrs. Harrison's school friend says, I'm sorry, Mrs. Cream, she said. I'm going to have to eat Carmela home from school. She's too much of a distraction, making calls from other parents. They're afraid those shirts may be contagious. Carmela was embarrassed. She couldn't believe what it was like her. Now she wanted to be in the same room with her. Her father tried to make her feel better. Sure. Do you think I can get this card? No, thank you. I'm sure you wanted it was a nice big plate of lima beans, but she lasted enough for one day. Well, then I see. I've grown some of the cream percent. The brand specialist of Europe. I'm back with four people with long wait coats. These are their creams. This is Dr. Group, Dr. Sponge, Dr. Craig, Dr. John. Actually, one worker killed it. These jabbed, tapped, and tested are very uncomfortable. It's not the mumps or the measles, not the chickenpox or sunburn. Try these, says the specialist. It's probably different color pills. Take one before each bed. That was for the fall by Dr. Bumble. That night, Carmela took her medicine. It was awful. She did feel it when she got her clothes and feel right. There was a giant multicolored pillow with her face in it. Wow. Dr. Bob rushed over to see Mr. Cream called. That's when he rushed to the experts. Dr. Gore, Mr. Malbron, the finest scientific minds in us, approached and prodded and looked at the list and wrote down lots of numbers and held together things. Might be a virus. Still another virus was appeared in Vermilia from bacteria. Or be a fungus. Then you go with different fungus blotches. After looking around, you look down. You get numbers. When we call you someone that do something, you should have a clue, much less a cure. By now, TV news have found out about Carmela. Card, every channel outside of her is telling the story of the bizarre case and the incredible changing kids. Even the crowd was camped out in front of the lawn. Creams were remedies, psychologists, allergies, herbalists, nutritionists, psychics, a medicine that grew, even a veterinarian. This only had poor Carmela's strange appearance. It's hard to even recognize her. Roots of berries and crystals and feathers even falling for a child. Nothing worked. Everyone called herself the environmental therapist, and she cure away. Close your eye, breathe deeply. Wish she had said that. And soon she smelled the walls of her house. Well, it became her mouth, her nose was a dresser, two paint, her eyes. So she ran for the house. She was just getting worse and worse. Her mistress grew quiet and knocked at the front door. She opened it. There's an old woman who was plump and sweet as strawberry. Excuse me separately, but I think it can help. She wanted to look around. My goodness, she said with a shake of her head. The woman has a bad case of stripes, the worst I've ever seen. She walks out with green beans for her face. Just by doing this trick. Are those magic beans, said Mrs. Cream? No, they're not such snakes. They're just playing lime beans. I wish you liked them, wouldn't you? You probably want a big plate of lime beans more than anything in the world. She was ready to admit it. Yuck, no one likes the beans but me. Well, I guess we're right about you, sir. It was just taste so good. Her love for you was nothing. There was no choice. Wait, so the Roy love line of eats. I thought so was for the point of Martha. Then the brain says, squeeze has this chair. Holes were around. That's how really, everything's back to normal. And Kurt, yes, I knew the girl you was there somewhere. Kurt went ahead. There's a wild sign dashing in a crowd. Afterwards, Kurt wasn't quite the same. All the kids in the section was wearing, but she didn't care about it. She all loved me. She never had a case of stripes again. The end.